There's nothing like chilling with my girls. Just me and my divas taking over the world.
Hey, you guys. So yes, it's another voiceover and it's a Week Encounters tutorial. So I got me a curly little bob here. So while I'm unsticking her, let's see how your wig comes.
You never feel the way I feel. You don't know if my love is real. Baby, listen to me, here's the deal. When you're not here, I'm not the same. I'm needing a new chapter, babe. Been stuck here in a bed for days. I've been staring at the telephone, 'cause when you're gone, I miss your face. Late o'clock, body talk. There's no need to bring it up. Nothing you say makes it better. Wrecking ball, tear apart. Issues left behind, restart. Nothing you say makes it better. Wanna give you up. I know we've been through way too much, but I'm confident we'll make it through. I'm here for you, you're not by yourself. Late o'clock, body talk. There's no need to bring it up. Nothing you say makes it better.
All right, you guys, so let's just start off by saying we all make mistakes. So I went ahead and bleached the unit, you know, the lace part, and didn't realize that the bleach was a little bit too runny. So it did seep through some of the hairs. So I'm gonna be using my hair dye right here. This is already mixed. It comes already mixed. You don't have to mix it, which means great. You don't have to discard it once you're done using it if you have a lot left. So all I do is take a mascara wand and I dip it into my actual hair dye and then I just brush it on. Now normally I do this on a mannequin head, which will make it so much easier and I'd be able to see everything. But because we're doing a tutorial, I'm going to show you guys how I try to fix the roots. So I used a color in a color dark brown, and this always seems to work for me, and you will see how it looks afterward. Now you don't have to blow dry it, but I normally do allow it to air dry, but because we're doing this video, I blew dry it and there it goes. I did miss a spot right there, so don't judge me. Like I said, I normally do this on a mannequin head, but I don't do it on a normal basis because, girl, I don't always do a mistake like that. But unfortunately, the bleach was a little bit runny and it did seep some of the lace. As you guys noticed, when you do receive the wig, there are some knots in the unit, and me particularly, I just like everything to be perfect. Now for one, of course it may look a little brassy at the hairline. That's due to my mistake with the bleach once again. And also, I normally put my blue shampoo onto the lace frontal and allow it to sit on for like 3 to 4 hours. I know Shimmer Lights purple shampoo does state just sit it on for 5 minutes, but girl, 5 minutes, you're still gonna look orange. So I normally leave it on for 4 hours and it comes out perfect. But I was really in a rush this day and I only left it on for 30 minutes. So yeah, now this part right here where I was just giving you a side peripheral view is me going ahead and cutting the excess lace off of the air tab part. I mean, I really do like for my wig to sit flush to my head, so that's the reason why I have to customize it. And this is mainly with a lot of the wigs because they do come average size head and we all don't have the same head shape or head length. So you may need to customize, like I'm showing you right here, your own lace front wig. It's definitely not going to take anything away from the wig, and it'll even fit better. Girl, it'll look like it's growing out of your scalp if you get it just right. So as you see, I'm just going to take the hairs and just part it on the hairline. I'm not using all these baby hairs, but doing this helps me adhere my wig a whole lot easier. So I'll take my bedhead and I'll only spray on the inside in that particular section. And then I'll go ahead and just spray on top. The reason why I don't spray all the way underneath around the entire perimeter is, well, the side part where the sideburns at, they never seem to stick as good. So you gotta put a little more reinforcement on them. And once I'm done applying that hairspray, I'll just take my blow dryer and blow the product dry. I like to use the rat tail comb because it'll really help. And I just go in between the hairs and just press down. That way it kind of lifts the hairs from laying so flush to your head. Like nobody's roots is growing flat out, you know? I just try to make it look as natural as possible. But girl, this hair is actually really, really pretty. And did y'all see the mannequin that Wig Encounters has the hair displayed on? For some strange reason, I really had to look at least like 3 times because it looks so realistic. I need me a mannequin like that. So if y'all know where I can get one, leave a comment, drop a comment. So now that I went ahead and cut those hairs in the front, I'm not gonna be using them all for wispy hairs, or which some may say baby hairs, but I just cut them just in case I want to one day. I just take my favorite Dollar Tree styling mousse, which is Salon Selectives, and I just start to brushing and sculpting with my favorite hair tool. Girl, this green toothbrush has been around with me for so many years and is still standing strong. You know she get a good washing every week. But as you guys see, this Salon Selective styling mousse to me is my favorite because I use it in all my videos. It doesn't make your hair crunchy or hard, and it doesn't lift your wig after you took the time out to apply it. Now I did forget to cut the hairs on this side. You know, like I said, we all make mistakes, and I realized the hair wasn't brushing the way that I wanted it to. So I went ahead and cut the sideburn hairs because everybody needs sideburns, and now I'm going to cut those little baby hairs. Now mind you, this is some undetectable Swiss lace, and it really actually is. It does look a little brassy, but I did fix that after this video. And I just take my toothbrush and I kind of like brush my hair in the front in an angle so that way it's not all brushed bluntly back. I wish I would have seen that little spot right there in the part prior to this video. But your girl does wear glasses. I'm nearsighted and far. And girl, let me tell you, everything looks perfect on camera to me when I'm recording. Now, I know you guys are probably wondering, why am I using a hot comb on some curly hair? Well, it's because I really wanted to see how flush this wig sits to my head. The curls in this are really pretty. I wish I could have looked like the mannequin, but hey, this wig still did me justice. I like the length of it, but mostly I do like the texture. It's like this really nice, soft, curly hair. And you know, I'm not the bob girl. Like I bob and weave, but listen, not the bob type girl, but I do like the curly ones. Now I'm just gonna take my next toothbrush and just brush the hairs up. I don't want them so flat to my forehead. And right here is where I'm gonna decide to just beat my face just a tad bit because, you know, I did keep that area of my hairline clean so that way I can apply the wig. So I'm just gonna touch up some spots. You guys definitely have to check out Wig Encounters. They got some bomb wigs. They're affordable, and girl, they have evolved so much. So check this one out. She is in 180% density, 14 inches, and so cute. Let me know what y'all think. I think this shirt makes me look a little bit fat. That's what I think. But let me know what y'all think. I love you all. Make sure you rate, comment, subscribe, okay? Share the video. And as always, stay diva and divalicious. And of course, I'll see you guys in the next one. Okay, peace out. Oh wait, hold up, hairline views. Yes, she's rather cute. I love you guys, happy dance, stay safe, bye.